Hey, what is up everyone? Today I wanted to give my first impression, well not my first, but you know, my impressions on the entire beta since it is over now, the technical preview for Halo Infinite. And I just want to give my impressions on it since the beta just ended. So first of all, I want to talk about the bots. The bots are actually pretty incredible. But no, they aren't perfect, but they are the best bots I've ever seen in a multiplayer game. Like, they're freaking smart. You know, the first day they had Marine Bot Slayer, then they had ODST Bot Slayer for the second day, and then Spartan Bot Slayer for the third day, and then they also added PvP, for the final day. But yeah, the bots were just, like, they were great, dude. The Spartan Bot Slayers were actually very difficult, and, you know, just as difficult as a, real player, in my opinion. So yeah, that's the bots. And next I wanted to talk about the weapons and abilities. So I really think they're balanced, yet also extremely satisfying to use. And I also think that they, had a really good variety for the beta. Like, they had many different types of weapons, and I think that's great. They were really interesting weapons. And I had a lot of fun using those. So, and then for the abilities, I really like the fact that they had like different grenades that you could pick up. So like they had the spike grenades, the you know, sticky grenades, and those were great that you can pick them up and you just get to keep your regular grenades on you, and you get to carry four grenades. That's pretty cool, you know. And then for the abilities, you got to, you know, get the threat sensor, which was really cool. You could, like, you know, shoot the threat sensor on the wall and then detect enemies is great. And then also the grappling hook was very cool to use. And I really enjoyed that. You could just zip around the map with that. And I just love the fact that all these things are pickups. Like, you can pick them up off the ground on the little pads that they have. And that's the same with the power weapons. So it makes it really fair in the game. You're not just like getting, you know, friggin' beasted by someone who maxed out their, you know, character and has every ability just unlocked on their character so that they can kill you. But yeah, as far as combat, the melee feels really good. I really, really, really hope they have assassinations in the final game, because like that is just, I feel like that and Halo go hand in hand, and I really, really don't want that to be missing from the game. And then there's also the overshield and active camo, which is, you know, the big pickup in the middle of the map, and I feel like those are really balanced. It's also really fun to friggin' sneak up on people with active camo, because, you know, sprinting is only about 2 to 3% faster than actual, just running with the stick. So anyway, yeah, you're only a little bit faster by running with sprint. So you can actually zip around with active camo on acquired. And still sneak up on people. It's really nice that they included that in the game. And obviously sprinting gives you access to sliding, but it also gives you your position away on the map. So, I mean, I use sprint just out of habit, but yeah, like, if you don't want to sprint, you don't have to. It's so great. So for the next part, I wanted to talk about the settings. So they have a wide range of settings, like just they have every setting you think of. They have motion blur, obviously. If you are over 60 FPS, you should probably turn that off. But there's also an FOV slider on console, which is very nice because I just love having a great range of control and being able to, you know, take charge and control how you play. And I think that's great. So next I'll talk about the customization. I think we have a pretty good amount of customization for only a preview, and I really think that it proves we'll be getting much more in the final game. Like, there's just a lot in this preview. I know it's kind of hard to unlock it all because it's in the battle pass, but at least we get to look at it all. And I just, you know, if you want to see all the customizations, you can go to my All Halo Infinite Customizations video. The link is in the description below. And then another thing I'm hoping for is some sort of like emblem or helmet or something for being a beta tester. That would actually be pretty sick if we got some exclusive stuff for, you know, testing the game. That would be really cool. So next I'll talk about the maps. I really liked all the maps, but I especially like the Bazaar map, which is the map we're seeing right now on screen. It definitely has like some Halo 2 vibes, and I really hope to see more interesting maps like this in the future. It's just like really interesting. There's a lot of hidden details. If you want to see that, you can also see my hidden details vid, which is in the description below as well, for Bazaar. And I really like this map, and I really hope to see more interesting maps like this in the future, and just less like boxy UNSC facility maps, because those do get old, you know. After a lot of Halo, the UNSC maps are getting old. So, and if you guys didn't know, the final day of the beta, we actually, you know, had real player versus player. I mentioned that earlier. But it was really fun. It really didn't feel much different from the bots, which is a good thing. And I really enjoyed what they gave us for this beta, and I'm hopeful for the future of Halo. But yeah, those were my overall thoughts on the first flight tech preview, and I remember, there will be more flights in the future, so don't forget to sign up for Halo Insider so you can get into it, and I'll be making more content on that when it comes out. But anyway, if you guys could hit that like button, subscribe down below, that would be amazing. And I hope you guys enjoy the rest of this Bazaar map gameplay. Bye!
Power items inbound.
Keep your head down.
Active camo inbound.
Need some damage.
Active camo available. Camo obtained. We're going quiet.
Victory.
Power items incoming. Power items up for grabs.
Camo is mine.
Target over there.
One minute remaining. Seconds remaining.
Enemies on me.
Lost a teammate.
Taking damage.
Victory.
Power items on the way. Power items available. Active camo obtained. We're going quiet.
Taking fire.
Picked up the ground. Yeah.
Down.
Enemy Spartans closing in.
me!
Minutes remaining.
Threat sensor acquired.
Spartan, take cover.
Let's find us some targets.
Another one down.
Active camo inbound. Threat sensors active. Active camo available. Camo inbound.
Taking damage.
Active camo available. Plasma grenades acquired. Let's murder some.
Taking damage. Dango's closing in.
The lead. Five minutes remaining.
Overcharging shields.
Thank you. down there.
Nearing victory.
Field.
Closing in.